This is 458 Oki with the Deerhurst channel, and we started out really rough with a hot, dry, windy muzzleloader season. But the second half turned out to be a lot better, and I actually put down two deer and actually got the kill shots on my GoPro, which wasn't ideal because apparently with the recoil, it kind of flipped it forward, but I did slow it down and did catch the kill shots, and also got some footage on my trail camera, video footage of me dragging the deer out. So join me for this episode, part two of muzzleloader deer season 2024. I'm not a professional. I'm just a regular guy who likes to hunt and basically likes to get meat in the freezer. Well, fifth day of muzzleloader season. It's getting a lot cooler out. There's going to be rain tonight. And so it's Wednesday, the fifth day of Oklahoma muzzleloader season 2024. And I'm about 25 feet up a tree on a good spot. I saw a deer coming in, a doe, but she was trotting away at quite a distance. I had no shot. So hopefully when it starts to get dark, I'll see her come through again or maybe a buck, but we shall see. I'll show you my view from here. Nice woodlot all around. Nice open woodlot. So stay tuned. Well, I just shot what looks like a doe from out of a tree, and I'm gonna go walk up and see how big it is. Hope there's not too much ground shrinkage. Didn't look like awfully big deer, but we'll find out. Looks like I got my antlerless tag filled. Muzzleloader season 2024. Let's go find it here. Dropped in the track, so shouldn't be hard to. Back there it is, right there. Little guy, well, medium size. Wow, just dropped right in his tracks. So, well, now the work begins. It's a little buck, it's like a yearling buck. So, anyhow, I guess I better get her taken care of, get her tagged, and hauled back to camp. Well, 458 Oak here, leaving Sportsman's Meat Block. Real nice fellers. His dad was here. I guess young man ran out to eat. Little sign right there says deer. Probably can't see it on here. It's dark. But anyhow, heading back to camp. Stay tuned. Well, good morning. Halloween. October 31st, and this youper is very happy. We got tons of rain last night, finally, after almost 2 months of drought. So, gonna head down to Wounded Tree. Filled one of my antlerless tags yesterday, and very happy about that. So I'm gonna get my stuff gathered up here and head down to Wounded Tree. Stay tuned. Beautiful morning. Woods are nice and quiet. Creek is flowing.
nice and still. Couldn't ask for a more ideal day to be out hunting. Shot a small one. Filled one of my antlerless tags yesterday afternoon. And had a little ground shrinkage. Wasn't as big as I thought it would be, but hey, got some meat in the freezer anyway, so could still get another antlerless and I can get a buck. So stay tuned. Evening sit on Halloween afternoon. Right here on one of my game cameras is a buck that I've been watching on the camera that I'm hoping shows up during the daytime. Only thing, I've only seen him at 8 or 9 o'clock at night. I'm hoping during the rut or during rifle season that I'll get a crack at him. Finally, a beautiful 40 degree morning. Third to the last day of Oklahoma muzzleloader season 2024. Set up in a woodlot just down from camp. And it's beautiful out here. Just enough light to start seeing stuff.
probably supposed to be this size.
Yeah, I know.
Got the buddy. Jack on that stupid tree, man. I went out there.
Well, for the deer cam video, Gary's touching up the warning fart zone sign. Need to make sure that warning was on there.
Yes.
It is a fart zone. So. And in this section, Papa Craze has a tall tale about how he got the deer that we found hanging in camp when we got back into camp. So you never know what to expect from Papa Craze. So I hope you enjoy this segment here. There's a almost the truth section and the truth section. So really interesting story from our beloved Papa Craze. Papa Craze, that's something else, huh? A fork and a spike? Cool.
Yeah, that's me what I killed him with. It wasn't no muzzleloader.
What do you kill him with, Papa Craze?
1917 Ford pickup truck.
Oh, 1917 Ford pickup truck. Wow.
Could have been 2017, I guess.
Oh. So, well, hey, got some meat in the freezer.
Just meat in the freezer. Cody Youngblood called the gang ranger out at the park. Gang ranger called me, said somebody just hit him. He was still kicking.
Oh, okay.
The passenger shot, asked him, could he shoot him? He said, yeah. The passenger, I did not see him shoot him. But he shot, normally I'd have walked up and shot him right there with a pistol.
Right.
But I think he shot him with a pistol, no exit wound. Shot him right here in the high flank and got busted the gut.
Huh. Well.
That was my hunting prowess.
I hear something out there.
That's right. Let's see him again.
Hey, is that you, Fred?
Yeah, it is.
Fred.
Fred.
Yo, okay. Fred. Well,
lost him on hat there.
Yeah, yeah. Well, hey, congratulations, Papa Craze.
I saved him my ammo.
Yeah.
I cleaned him with that, right?
Yeah, there. I saw that picture.
I like, wow. Yeah. And I jumped another buck, or I better not say buck. Boy, had a big white tail right there by my feet just now again while I go after that on my system. I was up there making all kind of noise, putting feet in my feeders. Back up there to my feeders with my foot, a little ladder. And I'm swinging up, climbing up there, clanging, putting in feed, climbed back down the ladder, climbed up, and I was doing like 25 pounds at a time.
Yeah.
And this one come out of the woods, I just froze.
Mm-hmm.
He's looking at my truck. He looked up at me, and I'm just on the ladder 6 feet. Mm-hmm. He looked at me, goes down, walked down, and went eating the corn.
What? So
he walked around my truck, around the front of the truck. He had to walk around it, he saw it.
Yeah.
He walked around, when he come there right beside the back of my truck, I jumped off the ladder, grabbed him by the horns, went to spurring and kicking him. I rolled him to the ground. Man, a bullet hole.
It's Papa Craze.
That's almost true.
Almost the truth.
Oh, buddy.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, little president man in the camper tonight.
Hey, let me see you
last night. Well, second to last day of Oklahoma muzzleloader season. Forecast of rain sometime today, but beautiful this morning. Stay tuned to the Deerist channel. We'll be right back. finally, I went back to my blind, and I had a real nice buck come cruising through, and I thought, oh gosh, he walked right through my shooting lane and disappeared into the thicket. And I thought, well, there goes my chance. But thank the good Lord, that buck must have smelled some of the corn. This was on private property where I had a corn feeder. And about 5 minutes later, he turned around and came back, and I was able to get a shot. So you'll see that footage here in this part of the video. Also, you know, when I went to look for the buck, the blood trail ran out, and I almost gave up hope. It was getting dark. The sun was setting. I was in a low spot. There was a ridge behind me. It was getting real dark. Had to run back to the pickup truck and get a better flashlight. And once again, I followed the blood trail as far as I could go and started doing a back and forth swath to try to pick up on the blood, which I didn't. And finally, you know, after I'd gotten the flashlight from the truck, I came back and I was doing a grid search, and I came on a little creek, whatever you want to call it. And my flashlight hit the water and I saw something unusual. It was actually some blood in the water. So you might have seen my short, blood in the water. And looked upstream and there he was. So here's the footage.
Found some blood.
Just shot a buck. And I think I heard it fall. But I'm going to try to recover it right now. Stay tuned. I think I got it on the GoPro too, the kill shot. Whew, I was following a blood trail. And it just started petering out, which is weird because it was a good shot. But I'm approaching a stream or something. I noticed something. Oh Lord, about the water. Look how red that water is. Look how red that water is. And there's the buck. Wow, cool. Yeah, medium-sized little buck. Get a look at it here. Well, actually, pretty nice-sized buck. Whoa, that was an angling shot. I shot on the other side shoulder, and it came out in the paunch. Oh my gosh, gave me a messy dressing job. Like a six pointer, and I know there's a real big one out here too. Maybe I'll get him during rifle season. But well, guys, now the work begins. I gotta get him dragged out. But that's funny, I lost track of the blood and then I saw blood in the water. How about that?
Heading to Bontrager's Deer Processing. They're staying open just for me. They're not open on Sundays. But anyhow, talked to them and they were very gracious. Stay tuned.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching the Deer Hearse channel. Thank you for tuning in. I'm just a regular guy who likes to hunt, and we like to get meat in the freezer. Our family enjoys venison year-round, whether it's in chili, whether it's in fajitas, or steaks. We usually have Bontragers, tenderize some meat.
Well, about to pull out of muzzleloader camp on the last day. It's raining. And I was going to show you the old fart zone trail here. There's got to be a place to poop in camp, So anyhow, aptly warned, warning fart zone. Enter at your own risk. But hey, it works. A little PVC and some cement and an old toilet seat. Tarp, sign of warning.